You know, I would say that this was an attempt to make an Indian Game of Thrones. But the problem is, it doesn't stand the wrath of time. Hello guys, I'm Nona Prince and today we're talking about the Tamil adventure film Ayyarathil Uruvan. It's a 2010 Tamil film written and directed by Selvar Raghavan, starring Karthi, R. Parthipan, Reema Sen, Andrea Jeremiah and many more. Shout out to Hari Krishnan who has been after me to watch this film. And here it is, finally I watched it. So you watched the film on Discord with other viewers of the channel. So if you want to join us in the future, do join Discord, link in the description. It was an action adventure and it was R-rated in a sense. It was adult. They were firing bad words, there was a lot of blood. And that's why I'm calling it GOT and not Lord of the Rings. Really like the story, you know, taking something historical and, you know, adding fiction to it. And the plot of her reaching this place and betraying and, you know, fighting and taking what's theirs. It was really well written. Now definitely it hasn't aged well at all. Now it did release in 2010, but they started shooting the movie in 2007 and it did face a lot of issues while the shooting was going on. But that is not an excuse how bad the first half is. The first and second half feels like two different separate movies. So let's talk about the first half. The tone is all over the place. It keeps oscillating from good moments to average moments to very bad moments. Things feel rushed and of course it's very commercialized. All the issues I have with the film throughout are the commercial elements added in the film. And it makes sense, they wanted to do good at box office and those were the norms that you need to have these things to promote a film and, you know, do good at box office. Knowing that this film didn't really have a star power, Karthi was not a big name by then, it was just his second movie. And the film had two female leads. And the film goes to places where it doesn't make logistical sense. It's just too much, it's going over the board. Things are becoming senseless, there are cringe fights and arguments between characters. The situations are so immature and over that the characters are behaving so immaturely. There's literally no coherency throughout the first half. I like the fact that in the first half there's no hero stuff. It's not like he's a hero, he can do anything. We see him crying, going through pain, getting hit. He's not one man army. Now before I come to the second half, guys, if you're finding value in the video, do the like button, because when you do that, YouTube promotes this video more, you can watch it. Also consider subscribing and the bell icon to get notification whenever a new video drops. Now second half was way better. As I said, it was a separate movie altogether. It was coherent, it was tonally consistent, the world was so beautifully set up, the cinematography improved by 100%, the camera movements, the shot selection was so good. I always love bringing Indian culture into the movies and how they use it in narrative storytelling. The whole dance form, the fight sequences, so well done, loved it. And I was really surprised that there were so less dialogues in the second half. It was more of visual storytelling. The whole war sequence at the end, so good. It was not just people fighting, it was choreographed. It had beats throughout. Of course, looking today, technically it doesn't really stand out, but I could clearly see the ambition, but the execution was not available to them at that time. We also see the aftermath of war. It's disgusting. It was so hard to watch those 10 minutes. I again felt they did went overboard, like some things really didn't make sense in that scene and some moments really felt forced, and the ending really surprised me. It felt like the film is trying to say the one side is really good and the other side is just plain bad. Now I don't have the context on all the history behind Chola dynasty and Pandya. Maybe Cholas were good and Pandyas were bad, I don't know. But the film does take it too far. But the ending really surprised me. It's not a happy ending at all. And it's kind of a cliffhanger that a sequel will come. And the sequel is coming in 2024 with Dhanush. Now coming to the songs in the movie. Mostly in the first half, they were like out of place. They were really good, you know, as a song. Just as a music video. They was really good and interesting, but they didn't fit in the movie at all. But I really like the dance sequences in the second one, you know. Even the king dancing, performing, you know. Again, coming to the cultural aspect of it. Now, definitely this film could have been an epic blockbuster, but maybe the timing wasn't right. They tried their best with all the budget and resources available to them at that time. Now, acting, first half, let's not even talk about. It was plain bad. Reema Sen, it felt like she's from another movie in this film. Like she's from John Wick. Second half, it improved so much. All the characters did really well. Again, the second half production design was so good. And there's a reason to it, because the second half is mostly indoors. So, you know, they can build sets and, you know, do whatever they want. But the first half is more of them, you know, going in the jungle and, you know, moving and going ahead. Maybe that's why it really doesn't work there. R. Parthipan really stood out for me. He was so good as that king. And I think the writing also helped a lot. I felt writing for Karthi and Andrea, there was not much. And Andrea was not just even there in the second half. She didn't do anything at all. But Parthiban was so good as a king. There were layers to him. He has that motivation backing him, you know, to become the king of his people. And I felt his emotions, you know, I felt connected to him. It was so good to see, you know, the love between the people and the king. And it was so beautifully depicted. There were a lot of great moments in the second half, you know, where that old guy commits suicide. He sacrifices himself so everything goes well. They came up with a nice innovation of showing romance through shadows. That was quite interesting. Where the king is betrayed, how people are stopping him from killing himself. You know, and a lot of scenes in the film reminded me of Bahubali. And I'm not trying to compare anything, you know, they are two separate films at separate times. But it's interesting to note what really worked for Bahubali and didn't work for this film. I think what Bahubali got right is the balance, you know, between the commercial elements, between the mass moments and the storytelling. If you see, Bahubali's stories is very simple, you know. It's a story we have seen a lot of times. It is inspired from Mahabharata. So they don't try to complicate the story. Instead, they spend that much time on the technical side of it. How to shoot it, you know, all the behind the scene post-productions. Because that side is very complicated. And that balance really works well for the film and becomes a better viewing experience. But in this film, there's so much going on. You have already made the story so complicated and so dense. And over that, you have all these technical things to take care that it just doesn't work out. Also, you know, the time plays a big factor. This film had that ambition, but it was not backed by the technology, which S.S. Rajamouli had. He was able to back his ambition by the available technology at that moment. And because of that, the execution in this film falls apart. Now, I know the sequel is coming out, but I think they should first remake this film again in Tamil. Same cast, same director, everything same, but remake this film. And the reason for that is, I want the sequel to really work throughout India. But the problem is, it is a sequel. So people would want to watch the first one, right? And when they watch the first one, I'm telling you, 50% of people will stop watching the movie with the first half. Because it's so bad. It just throws you off. Now, I had to review the film. I had other people watching with me on Discord. So I had to complete the full film. Otherwise, I would have also stopped watching the film after an hour or something. You know, so much is going in this film that you can make three separate movies out of it. So I think if the remake happens, you should cut down the story. Remove things are not necessary. Let's just make it a journey of three people going there. Maybe they are friends, maybe they are colleagues or something, you know, and they are on this journey and they finally reach this place and then explore more of this world, you know. We get to know about this world so late in the movie and then there's no time to explore the world, how this all works, you know. There's literally no explanation to things what happens in this movie. Like, how did they reach there? What happened in the interval time? Why did they go crazy? How have they survived for so long? There's so many questions which are unanswered in the film because there's so much going on plot-wise. So you have to cut these things out. Now, of course, I don't think we'll get a remake. I don't think it's possible logistically because they're already working on the sequel. Now, definitely times have changed. They have good budget. They have good technology available. They will definitely make a better film and I'd be looking forward to it. So guys, that was the video. Definitely there were a lot of moments in the film I wanted to talk about, but I thought the video was getting too long, so I cut that all out. Let me know if you want to do a live discussion on this film. It'll be interesting. And I've been told to watch the moving image video about this film. So I'll be watching it after this. Or maybe you can get Kishore on the live stream and talk about this film. So let me know if you want that in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button, share this video, let me know in the comments your thoughts. If you are subscribed yet, check out the videos. If you like them too, do consider subscribing and I'll see you next time.